The following is a presentation of CW Sports.
Tonight, the River City rivalry renews as the Cincinnati Bearcats collide with their border rival, the Pitt Panthers. It's the debut of ACC football on the CW.
Game now, me and you, we ain't the same now. Lions coming out to play now. Opposition out the way now.
Out of the way, you wasn't invited. Say you come to play, I dare you to try it. You don't wanna try me, then step up to my team. Yeah, out of the way, yeah, yeah. Out of the way, yeah, yeah.
We're live in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, high above Acrisure Stadium in the Steel City. The 13th all-time meeting between Pitt and Cincinnati. These two teams have not met in over a decade, and they are just about set to go head-to-head. ACC football on the CW is presented by Verizon My Plan, the plan for fans. And as the Panthers take the field, our matchup tonight, the Cincinnati Bearcats out of the Big 12 and the Pittsburgh Panthers from the Atlantic Coast Conference here in the Steel City. It is so great to have you with us for ACC football on the CW. Tom Wormy along with James Bates. And James, this is just the start of a sensational season on the CW, and we kick it off with the rivalry that is Pittsburgh and Cincinnati.
And it almost might as well be the start for these two teams for this season. Both come in 1-0 tonight, but these fans of these teams both know it was a little bit of a stroll through week one. The true test comes tonight. And I don't think it's just Cincinnati fans and Pitt fans that need to be excited about this matchup. I think college football fans should be excited about this good one we've got tonight on the CW.
And watching these quarterbacks as well, they both transferred into their respective programs. And in week one, they got it done, throwing the ball and running the ball. Let's start with Phil Dracovic back in town, back in his hometown, and winning games for the Panthers.
And back to his old ways. Watch him here on this read. Perfect read on the end there, crashing down. Turns the corner, and look at this, Pitt fans. You got to be excited about your guys blocking downfield. That's Bub Means in the corner, an easy stroll into the end zone. And, oh, yeah, just like he did for years at BC, Dracovic extending plays. This time throwing, falling backwards off of his back foot and just lacing it in there to his tight end, doing what he does best. Emory Jones can run, too, but he doesn't always look down the field for that receiver. Sometimes he'll tuck it, and he'll look for that goal line just like he does right here, a hop, skip, and a jump into the paint. First series of last week's game, 4th and 5. Who does he go to? His old teammate from the University of Florida, Xavier Henderson. 4th and 5, 49 yards later, first touchdown of the day. And oh, by the way, first touchdown of 7. He counted for 7 touchdowns, a school record at Cincinnati. They put some faith in him. He's got to be feeling good right now.
And we are just moments away from sparking up this rivalry once again, the Pitt Panthers and the Cincinnati Bearcats.
Can't be denied. I got a lot on the line. This with a different approach. Only spend time in the boat. I give it all that I got.
Whoa, so this is your plan? Watching with this crew from work.
Well, Josh Allen, I have to watch their NFL Sunday Ticket.
That's not a great plan, but this is my plan from Verizon. Switch now and get NFL Sunday Ticket from YouTube TV on them.
I'm really into this plan.
And they're really into whatever this is. I wouldn't.
I won't.
Football season is here. Get NFL Sunday Ticket from YouTube TV on us, a $449 value. Plus, get a free 5G phone only on Verizon.
It's back. Applebee's all-you-can-eat boneless wings, just $12.99. When you have something to get done today, getting everything you need today is helpful. That's why Ace has free in-store and curbside pickup, or even same-day delivery from your locally owned neighborhood Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Today, anything is possible.
Today, anything is possible.
The possibilities are endless when we start clean.
Anything is possible.
Have fun, sis.
Can't stop adding stuff to your cart? Get the Bank of America customized cash rewards card. Choose the online shopping category and earn 3% cash back.
That looks really high.
It is high.
Whenever you're ready.
Are there any snakes?
Nope.
You sure?
Here we go.
It's time to push your limits.
You're doing great.
Whoa, is that a buffalo?
Babe, that's a cow.
The all-new Subaru Crosstrek Wilderness. Adventure on the edge.
Back in Pittsburgh, and it's time to welcome in the third member of our broadcast team. Let's send it down to the field and Trevor Scales.
Here with head coach Pat Narduzzi. Coach, what's the key to victory tonight?
We got to go out and play Pitt football. You know, worry about ourselves. You know, I think they got a great football team. We got a great football team. It's got to come down to making plays, and we just got to play within ourselves and play one play at a time.
How do you make sure that defense locks down an offense that just put up 600-plus yards last week?
Well, everybody's got to do the job. You know, you got 11 guys out there. They got 11. Everybody's got to do their individual job. Our kids talk about 111. Do your 111, and we're good to go.
We not me, right, Coach?
That's right.
Have a good one, Coach. Best of luck.
Thank you, Matt.
Thank you, Trevor, and we look forward to your reports all evening long. Scott Satterfield is the first-year head coach for the Bearcats, but he is familiar with the ACC. In fact, he was the coach of the year as the head man at Louisville back in 2019 and went 8-5 that season. He's also been the head coach at Appalachian State. That was 2013 to 2018, and shepherded that program into the Football Bowl subdivision. And so Satterfield paces those sidelines. Look at that view, James Bates, high above Acrisure Stadium. It is perfect. How about 74 degrees to kick it off with the light breezes? Forget that chance of rain. We're going to play college football in the ACC between Pitt and Cincinnati. A.J. Woods will be the deep man for the Panthers to accept the opening kickoff as Cincinnati won the toss, elected to defer. Rory Bell will kick it away for the Bearcats. 1-0 with a win at home last Saturday against Eastern Kentucky. Pittsburgh won on this field against Wofford out of the Southern Conference a week ago, 45-7. The football is in the air in Pittsburgh. So the Panthers will have the ball to start the game. Phil Jurkovic from right here in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, will lead him out there, Bates, for this opening series.
Yeah, welcome back. Back home where Pitt fans feel he belongs and maybe should have just stayed, coming right out of high school. An incredible career in not only football, but basketball as well at nearby Pine Richland, about 17 miles to the north. But he went to Notre Dame, transferred to Boston College. ACC fans certainly know that. Played very well, especially early on for his, once again, offensive coordinator, Frank Cignetti, when he was there at BC.
Kovic threw 35 TD passes for the Eagles. Escapes the pocket, throws on the run, and incomplete. That one aimed at Rodney Hammond Jr. Reschick, number 9 for Cincinnati, had the coverage. Second down after the incompletion from Jurkovic.
Reschick is going to be fun to watch. Number 9 on that defense for the Bearcats. He plays that same spot, ACC fans, as Yasir Abdullah. You'll remember him as a big-time playmaker for the Cards the last few years, not only for Satterfield, but the defensive coordinator, Brian Brown, who travels over and is now the DC in Cincinnati.
Second and 10, Jurkovic, the deep ball, down the sideline, adjusting to the pass, but it is caught out of bounds by Bob Beans.
Boy, this is exactly what you're looking for Pitt, is that back shoulder throw. There were a couple early that Cincinnati was turned around on EKU that they didn't quite complete, so you knew they were going to go for it, but ball thrown out of bounds and a little bit too far behind. Otherwise, it's up there near midfield and a first down. Instead, it's third down and long, and a big third down here.
Pitt was seventh in the conference a season ago at 40% on third down. Dracovic has the time, unloads another one. And that is way behind the intended receiver, Bob Means. So it is three and out for the Panthers on the opening possession.
Frustrated Phil Dracovic right there, smacking his hands. You see as he comes over to the sidelines. And, you know, going back to that first play, it was right back to the old school for him, buying a little bit of time, lacing one in there. But it was just a great defensive play to make sure it went incomplete. And then two more incomplete on that drive. So a quick 1-2-3 and a great stand by the defense.
Caleb Junko, number 91, is the punter for Pitt. Brayden Smith is the deep man for the Bearcats. Smith to his right at the 32. Dances up towards the 35, where he is forced out of bounds. Brandon George, special teams play for Pitt. And now we get our look at Emory Jones, the senior from LaGrange, Georgia. He's played at Florida, he's played at Arizona State, and now he